Hi everybody, this is Denise with PurplePaperParadise.com, and today I am sharing with you a really cool feature that is part of Make the Cut. And I've actually only done this once, and it's with this particular project, so I learned quite a few things about it as I was doing this project and putting it all together. First off, you can see on the screen that I have a design here. This is something that I put together using this tree, and all the leaves and everything are from SVG Cuts Edisto Island SVG set. And then I have a couple of fonts here. This one I believe is Lettering Delights Cotton Candy, and this one here is Verdana Leaves. And I put this together on a small scale. You can see that I'm on a 12 by 12 mat right now. I actually do have, even though I'm going to be cutting this in my eCraft, and I normally do this with a portrait orientation, I do have this landscape, and there's a reason for that here, and I'll share that here with you in a little bit. But what I'm going to be doing with this design is I'm going to be using the Tiler feature to enlarge this so that I can cut this out in vinyl and put this on a 30 inch by 24 inch canvas. And so let's go ahead and I'll show you how I went about doing this. First thing that we're going to do is we're going to hit select all so that we make sure every part of our design is selected. And if you look over here in my layers feature, you'll see that I have everything separated out in layers initially. And that is definitely something that you want to do before you try to enlarge everything. So the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to go to this wrench, which is the advanced menu, and we're going to select Tiler. Now here you'll see that our design is showing in the preview window here. It shows us our actual width and height, and then we can put in our new width and height. Now I have this 30 inch by 24 inch canvas, and I know that I'm going to have it go landscape, so my height is actually going to be the 24 inches, but because I want to make sure that I have some margin on the sides, I'm actually going to put this in at 22 inches. So I've got about a 1 inch margin on top and bottom. And you'll see then that it changes my width so that it accommodates and it comes to the 24 inches. Now if I put in my 28 inches here, you'll see then that my height goes to 25. So that's why you got to kind of play around with these measurements to see what works best for you. Now I'm going to use some roll vinyl that I have. So my tile width is going to match my width of the whole design. And then the roll vinyl that I have is actually a 9 inch vinyl. So I'm going to put my height at about 8.5 inches. I want to, again, leave a little bit of a margin, because if I put in 9 inches, then basically it's got to cut from edge to edge, and that'll be a little difficult to line up. So I just want to make sure that I've got a little bit of a margin there. And actually, you know what, I think I'm going to go ahead and take it down to 8 inches just to be safe. I'd rather use some extra vinyl and just make sure that I get it cut right the first time instead of trying to squeeze too much in there. So now let's talk about these offsets. I'm going to take these to zero here, and let's go ahead and hit preview. And as you can see here, it then shows me each section. So here I've actually got, it looks like three sections. It might be a little bit over here for some reason, which I don't really understand, but I'm not sure about that. So here you can see that we've got all of our tiles. Now let's say, for example, like we've got this one where it's giving us a break, which is actually going to be a seam where two pieces of vinyl are going to butt up against one another, and it's doing that right in the middle of these words. So what I actually want to do is I want to try and offset this a little bit. Now you'll notice that right up here is the very, very top, and then I've got a margin down here. So I don't want to do anything with my X offset, because that's from right to left here. I want to work a little bit with my up and down offset. So that would be my Y coordinate. And if you put in a negative value here, it actually moves the whole tiles up a little bit. So for example, if I put a -1, and hit preview, you can see that it has shifted up a little bit. So, and then if I put in a positive one, it actually shifts down, but then you'll see that part of your design is being cut off here at the very top. It doesn't, for some reason, it doesn't put in another tile here for you automatically. And I'm not quite sure why that is. It's probably a bug here in the program. But I'm going to go ahead and just play around with these measurements a little bit to see if I can get that seam to be away from the words. And as you can see, I'm kind of close here. The seam is like right on top of these words here, and there's a little bit of a margin down here. So I'm just playing with this a little bit to see if I can get a little bit better. And I think that's probably good here. Another, it's kind of hard to see on this little screen, so you kind of have to go with what you have here. Now, one thing that I've kind of uncovered as I was doing this too is that one of the best things that you can do is take a picture of this window before you accept the design. So I just used my window snipping tool, and I can actually just go around it like this, and then I've got this picture that I'm going to save. And I'm just going to get out of that right now because I don't need it, to show you how to do this. But then we're going to go ahead and hit accept. And now you may be like, I don't see anything, nothing changed. Well, actually it did, because if you look up here, you're going to see default pages. So let's go ahead and take a look at these pages. I'm going to zoom out here. This first one, as you can see, is the first part of our design, the very top of it. And then here is the middle section. And here's the last section. And actually, those words turned out perfect, so I'm very happy to see that. And then there's this one here, which is showing that there's like a little slice of a leaf here somewhere. So that's fine. We can always throw that in at some point here, but we're going to leave it as it is here right now. Now, if you go to your default page, that's going to show you your entire design as it originally was in the original size. Now, one thing that I've kind of discovered too when I was doing this is when you hit select all, if you notice here, and I'm going to zoom in so that you can see this better, there's a dot here. See that there? That tells you where the center of the design is. And that is something that's kind of key for putting this together, because when you actually go to cut this out, you want to know where your center point is, and then take something that is either directly on top, like directly in the center, or something that's around it, and put that down first so that everything else then can build off of it. So when I put this together, I actually did this dark green leaf, and I had this center point right here in the middle like this, and then I built everything off around it. Now, when you go to these pages, and let's zoom out again so you can see better. The reason why you wanted to put these all on layers before you did this is because you'll see here then is that everything is on a layer again. So I can actually go to hide all, and I can select just my brown for the tree, cut that out, and then hide all, go to my next one, cut that out, cut that part out. So that's why it's kind of key to making sure that you've got all your layers in place before you do the tiler, because trying to do that afterwards I think would just be very confusing. But then what I do is I take that picture and I kind of just mark on that page 1-1, 1-2, 1-3, so it kind of helps me visualize what I need to do. And then when I went to cut these out, what I actually did was I cut out the, like I said, I cut out that green leaf first, and I put that in the center. But then, because just about everything in this design revolves around the brown tree, I went back to each one of my layers and cut out the browns next and put those on the canvas, and then went back and added in all the other leaves and everything else to it. If you want to see more about how I put this all together, please go to my blog, purplepaperparadise.com, for my post on October 11th, 2011. And I did take a bunch of pictures throughout the process of when I was putting this all together so that you can see better how I went about doing it. This was a very interesting project to do, and there was a couple things that I think I would do differently if I were doing this again. Like, for example, these names that I put on the tree, which are for my family, I cut those out of the same brown as the tree. And I would probably use this green instead because the names get a little bit hidden. They were a little bit too dark. But also, too, the other thing that I would probably do is I used some outdoor vinyl to do this because I wanted to make sure that it would last. But that means that it was very difficult to get things lined up and it was kind of frustrating. And there are some mistakes on mine for sure. And so, if I were doing this again, I would definitely use either indoor vinyl or even I was thinking that square one, even though it means I would have a lot more seams, I think that product would be just amazing on this kind of project. So, that's the Make the Cut Tiler for you. This really is a very versatile tool to use. It's very well thought out with a couple of little things in there that, could probably be improved upon, but overall, it worked very well, and I'm very happy with the results. If you have any questions for me, please feel free to send me an email, and please visit my blog, purplepaperparadise.com, for more information on this project. Thanks, and have a great day.